What's up, Zombie Slayers? This is KJ48, and welcome back to my 7 Days to Die single player Let's Play. This is episode 36, and we are going to run over to the... What did we call the new base? What did you guys name it? The Killing Cage. We're going to go over to the Killing Cage, and we're going to grab some spikes, and we're probably going to also make us up some... Actually, I didn't make them yet. Do I have what I need on to make me? I don't think so. Actually, on the way over there... Let's go ahead and cut some trees. Over during the night, I did completely run out of wood. I was working in my mind for a little bit, and you know, in my mind, I'm trying to make it organized. So instead of having just a bunch of crazy tunnels going up, left, down, right, and everywhere else, instead of having crazy tunnels go up, up, down, left, right, BA, and start, I figured I would just make them organized. But the thing is, because I'm making them organized, it's taking quite a bit of wood. So we're going to cut down some trees here, and we are going to get ready for the 49-day horde. I did like the barbed wire fencing, so we're going to go ahead and make some of that. 189, we don't need that much, but let's just make 50 for now. And I'm probably going to also make some barbed wire fencing as well. Now, the reason I'm making the barbed wire fencing is because I wanted to put it on top of the spikes. The barbed wire fencing on top of the spikes... I don't know if it's really that good, but I'm going to put it up there anyway because, I don't know, extra defense, right? It doesn't take a lot. Any little bit can help. So let's get the barbed wire on top of there as well. We'll put the standing barbed wire right behind the spikes, or right in front of the spikes, and we'll put the regular barbed wire on top of the spikes. Oh, I still have quite a bit of regular barbed wire. Let's not make those yet, though. We're going to make a lot of this standing barbed wire, though. We're going to make some of this barbed wire fence, though, because the barbed wire fence is awesome. I'm also going to take stock of the bricks here. I still need a shoot ton of bricks, a crap ton of bricks, a feces ton of bricks. So I wasn't sure about that. I wasn't sure how many bricks I would need, so I didn't make any, but I'm going to have to get some clay and make some more bricks, but that's going to be a day 50 thing. We're not going to worry about that right now. Today, we are going to get the Morningstar Outpost ready for day 49. And, should be fun. I don't expect it to take all day, though, so I'll probably do some looting afterwards. The thing is... Oh, we also have some screamers, so hold on. Let me get my business face on. All right, you guys can't see it right now, but this is my super serious business face. What the hell was that? Oh, don't worry about you. Where'd she go? Did they despawn or something? Because she might have killed herself on the spikes, I guess. Yeah, they've been up here causing trouble all day. Like an idiot, I'm like, well, I'm going to go out there and work up here for the day. So what did I do? I ran my forges for the entire night. Just dumb. Not the way you want to do things. It does not seem to be an issue, though, because there's nothing up here. We want to make sure we don't have any steel on us. We do not. We do have some wood, although it's probably not enough, but we will just do what we can now. And if I have to go chop down some trees, I will pause the video because nobody needs to see that. Alright, so we can get most of the spikes from the inside, but I'll repair some out here if I can, because why not? There's no reason not to repair them from the outside. Now, there's one more layer of spikes you can do past what they are right now. You can turn them into steel spikes. Steel spikes is quite expensive, because steel is an expensive material, so I'm not doing it for the Morningstar base, but I will be turning them into steel spikes for the Killing Cage. I'm gonna have a hard time remembering that. You know how I'm gonna remember the Killing Cage? There's a comic book called The Killing Joke. It's a Batman comic. I never read it, but it's like, I think it's one of the ones that they did, like, you know, most recent ones, like the ones, what was the first one? Batman Begins or whatever. You know, like all the new Batman comics. There's one called The Killing Joke. And I'm supposed to be like a really, really good... Like, not a comic, but more like a graphic novel. So, I've heard of it, although I've never read it. Alright, so we still got... Oh my goodness, screamers. Still got some screamers coming in. She didn't see... Oh, zombie bear. Okay, I'm waiting to fight a zombie bear. So let's get rid of some of these punk asses. And then let's go and smoke a zombie bear. Alright. You see him? He's right... Where'd he go? Is he wandering around? Am I just seeing things? Oh! I don't have anything to kill him with. I could have swore I saw him. I don't know. Maybe I didn't. Yeah, I guess I was just seeing things. I probably saw one of these things and thought there was a zombie bear. Zombie bears are no joke. I could probably take them with the bow and arrow, but I just, you know, it's not really worth the time. I'd rather just not fight them. But when I said I was going to get one, I thought I had my, like, magnum on me. I was like, oh, wait, I don't. And I was like, oh, well, the hell with it. The area should be calming down as far as the heat map goes. For those of you who are not aware, I give a lot of like new player tips, guys. So when I say for those of you who are not aware, you know, I'm probably gonna say something pretty basic. So, but anyway, for those of you who are not aware, the screamers come in because of heat. Heat is generated by doing things like building, having zombie corpses around, stuff like that, gore blocks, whatever. But the main thing that does it is the big thing that causes heat is the forges in the campfire. So when you run a forge or a campfire, you're gonna generate a lot of heat in the area. Not heat as in like, you know, you're gonna get hot. Heat as in it's just making it. Basically, the zombies kind of sense your activity and they send a screamer, which is kind of like, think of the screamer as like a scout zombie. And they scout it out, and if they see you, they yell, and then when they yell, they call in more screamers. So, that's how that works. Okay, so how am I doing this? Yeah, let's do this. Yes, this is the way this is supposed to go. Okay. So, let's go ahead and put these down right here. Not much room to work with there, but enough. Come on. There you go. Okay, now what we'll do is we'll take this barbed wire and put it on top of the spikes in the back. But before we do that, let's go ahead and upgrade these. And now what we'll do is we'll put these on the spikes in the back. I've been told these regular barbed wire things I use are not really that effective anymore, but I don't know. Like I said, every little bit helps, and I think they look cool, so that does influence my decision, although maybe it shouldn't. All right. Nope. You guys gonna die on my spikes or what? Oh! Right in the head. Oh! Booyah! Hey, stop breaking my spikes, you jerk. The problem is with these spikes is once they get on the ground, they tend to just beat on your spikes pretty badly. But whatever. I think they're pretty cool, and I think they do help. Every little bit helps, right? I was debating using landmines again. Now here's why I'm not going to use landmines. Gunpowder is really hard to come by, and landmines. Okay, think about a landmine. I don't think that landmines actually have an AoE effect, although they could. I will admit that the landmines could have an AoE effect, and if they do, they might be a little bit better than I'm thinking, but even with an AoE effect, like one landmine is going to kill maybe one or a couple zombies at most, and then it's gone. You know, I just don't think that's worth it. I just don't think that's worth it, especially with how hard it is to get gunpowder these days. You know, what? Worst case scenario, landmine only kills one zombie. Best case scenario, landmine kills a couple zombies, but once it goes off, that's it. And yeah, you could put a lot of them out there, but still, that's, you know, this is a little... I think next time I do this, I'll leave two spots in between the fence and the next set of spikes. Just to give myself a little bit more room to work. But yeah, that's why I decided ultimately not to use landmines. Madmole himself said that landmines are really good and they should be used. But, you know, unless they're going to reset themselves, you know. I mean, I just don't see it. I mean, if you guys are having successful landmines, by all means, let me know. You know, I just want to hear someone say something good about them. So far, I've heard no one say anything good about landmines yet. So, take that for what you will. Ooh, is there a spot there for a block? There is. We should go get some blocks. And make sure we plug up those holes in the ground. One hole in the ground isn't so big of a deal, but once you start getting a couple, they could start digging in there. Man, those two guys don't even care about me. They're like, whatever, bro. They're like, whatever. Actually, I might be doing this defense thing the whole day. I didn't think I was going to be, but maybe. It's possible. Now, what we got to do is remember... what am I telling you to remember? It's up for me to remember. I'm kind of talking to myself, too. Just remember, as soon as the horde starts, that's when I need to start dragging the zombies around. Oops. Stupid barbed wire! I am your master! You're not supposed to hurt me! So yeah, as soon as they come in, start dragging them around. Drag them early, finish them off later on, you know, stop dragging them around at that point. But yeah, I'm definitely going to drag them early. I think that's a really good plan. See, I mean, I don't know if Last Horde was just a fluke, but it was really, really soft. And I don't know if it was my defense. I don't think it was because... Well, you know what it was? It was my guns. My guns were killing them a lot quicker. That's the basic idea. And once I get my main base done, once the killing cage is done, I'm definitely going up to warrior difficulty. No doubt. No doubt. And I don't have to continue. I don't have to completely finish the killing cage to start doing hordes there. All I have to do is finish the outer defense, and then I can start doing hordes at the killing cage. So, you know, it might not be as long as, you know, it might seem. Okay. All right. Doing pretty good here. Oh, you son of a beeswax. No, I'm gonna break that out. Just gonna get my way. At least I break him out quick. Hey, how many? Oh, it takes 8. Okay. So it took 8 iron to put that down. When I broke it up, I got 3 back. Yeah, okay. Son of a... All right, this one's got to come up. This one has got to come up. Keep missing it. Okay, let's do this. Can't put anything there for now. You know what? Let's look at that block. I've come to the conclusion I'm not going to use the bow during the Horde Nights anymore. So, you know, I'll just might as well use them on these zombies. Okay. There you go. What the hell is your problem, woman? Die, sexy nurse! Sit, lay down, sexy nurse, you're dead. Look at the veins. I gotta tell you, man, the veins really are a turnoff. Gotta get that looked at. Anyway, let's, we're running out of these, huh? Alright, let's make another 50. The hell with it, we're gonna need them. Because we're gonna be using these on the killing cage as well, so there's no way we can make too many of them because I'm gonna be using them a lot. So, yeah. There's that. Alright, so let's use more barbed wire here. Put these right on top. You want to put it on, like, right there, and then put it on the spike behind it. It's a little tricky. It's a little tricky. But it can be done. We don't have anything on the inside, do we? On the inside side of... In the inside set of spikes. I probably should, shouldn't I? Well, no, you really don't need this barbed wire on the inside... The inside. What the hell is wrong with me? The inside set of spikes. Because the whole idea of the barbed wire is to hold them on these spikes. Now, the small spikes will... stop a zombie anyway. Like, they pretty much bring them to a stop. But I want to use the big spikes because the small spikes break too easily. But the big spikes have no, like, slowing down ability at all. But the big spikes last longer. So, that's the idea. You need something to hold the zombies on the big spikes. Now, the big spikes are going to do... A lot of people say, oh, the little spikes do so much damage. And it's true. The big... Come on, are you freaking kidding me with this? Let's use this. Hold on a sec. I will finish my thought in a second. Okay. The big spikes will do overall more damage than the little spikes. The little spikes, every time they do damage, they take damage. Well, all the spikes are like that. But the little spikes have so little hit points, they break up too easily. So it might seem like, oh yeah, man, the big spikes, oh, they do so much damage. And they do, but over the run of their entire Horde Night, the big spikes will do more damage overall. For less room, I should say. Like, maybe if you had a whole field of small spikes, you'd get more damage out of it. But spike per spike, if you can hold the zombies on the big spike will do more damage. That's just, I mean, I've never done any tests, but that would be the logically, that's what I've seen in my Horde Nights. The little spikes simply break out too easily. So yeah. So that's the whole thinking behind these big spikes, and that's why I'm using the barbed wire. You don't really need the barbed wire on the inside row. Because the inside row is already doing its job because they stop because they're beating on the walls. Okay? So that's why you don't really have to worry about the inside row. Yeah, that makes sense. Okay. Yeah, so that's the idea of the barbed wire, people. All right, so we got a bunch of that. Okay, so let's go ahead and fix these. These aren't being fixed. Let's just leave them there. The hell with it. They'll get broken out or not. I don't know. It's kind of weird you can't fix these. Oh, there we go. Yeah, I thought that was kind of weird. Nothing in this game you can't fix. All right, so let's put down some more spikes. I'd really like to get some looting done today, but this is taking a little bit longer than I planned. I mean, I don't really have to put another row of defenses out, but eh, why not? This game's all about defenses, man. Like, this is what I love about this game. The thing that first drove me to this game when I read about it on Kickstarter was Tower Defense Zombie Survival Game. I mean, come on, man. Like, that's awesome. One thing I kind of am a little down about this game is I feel it's lost its tower defense a little bit in favor of an active defense. Like, but I guess it depends on what you consider tower defense. Like, when I consider tower defense, I think of setting up defenses and watching them kill whatever's attacking you. But I guess in a lot of tower defense games, you're still doing damage. Like games like what's the game I was thinking about? Orcs Must Die. You're still in there actively doing damage. So yeah, I guess that's fine. I guess that could be considered. Yeah, yeah. So it's still tower defense. Yeah, it's just like when I first started playing tower defense, I was playing things like it was some mod for Warcraft 3, and I think that was one of the first tower defense games ever. And it was some mod for Warcraft 3, and you basically just put the towers up, and they killed everything for you. So, but I guess that I could see how that maybe people can think that would get old. Never got old for me, but can't argue with the idea that that might get old. So. Yeah, so, but that's what drove me to this game. Tower defense, I'm in. And, yeah. And I haven't been disappointed. There's been some things that the Fun Pimps did that I didn't agree with as much. But, overall, I'm on board. I love it. This game's great. I mean, I'm playing it for 3 years. Would I have been playing it as much if I wasn't doing YouTube videos on it? Yeah. Yeah, I would. Because the thing is, YouTube in the long run, I would. I might not still be playing at the end of every alpha like I do now. I'd probably wait for the next alpha and come back. But the thing is, overall, I would probably put more hours into it if it wasn't for YouTube, because YouTube holds me back as far as how long I want to play the game for. You know what I mean? So maybe I still wouldn't be playing these end of alpha releases. And what I mean by end of alpha is like when an alpha comes out, you know, probably about 2 to 3 months later, I think a lot of people drop off. Maybe probably 2 months later, a lot of people drop off. And that's because, you know, they're waiting for the next alpha and they've done everything and that's that. But they don't play like I play. I play a couple hours a day. I make videos. Actually, not even a couple hours a day. I mean, I make, what do I make? 4 videos a week for single player? So just, if you're talking about just single player, you know, I'm not playing as much. Although I do a lot of grinding off camera. So, you know, it's a little bit more than you guys think. But yeah. Yeah, I love this game. This game was made for me, it really was. And I just saw Mad Mole's most recent Alpha 16 preview video things and what they're going to be doing with electricity and stuff. And man, I'm really excited. I'm really excited. I'm glad that these developers take this game seriously and are going to, you know, support the hell out of it. And, you know, as a player, that's all you can ask for. Part of the reason, it's another reason I love this game so much, man. The devs take it seriously. A lot of these early access games, actually, I'm not going to say that. A lot of people say a lot of these early access games are being abandoned. That's not really true. At least not the games I've been playing. Yeah, I know there's been abandoned games out there. I do know that. And that does suck. But I think they're kind of few and far in between, at least for the ones I play. See, now that's what I get for not paying attention. I got off the bike to chop these trees down. And I never freaking got back on it to come home. Like, what the hell was I thinking? You know, I was just engrossed in my commentary, just trying to, you know, just talking about stuff that I'm really interested in, and it kind of pulls me in, and I just, you know, forget where I put my mini bike, and it cost me an airdrop. Eh, whatever. Probably without anything good in it anyway. Or maybe had the AK part I needed. Who knows? We'll never know. All right. So, anywho, let's see where we are. Oh, yeah, I got to grab that thing. Come on. Up, up, up. There we go. Pro skills right there. Alright, so, oh god, this place. This place is just a freaking mess. Just a mess. Man, you know what? I thought we would be able to do this relatively quickly. Nope, this is gonna be all day. We're not gonna be able to loot. Oh well. Ah, well, what are you gonna do? That's what happens. You know, a lot of this damage was because of the screamers, honestly. Like, I mean, the part that got hit during the horde is whatever, but a lot of this happened when I got screamers. So, you know, that's what you're going to do. If you're going to have a, you know, a forge right underneath your base, you're going to have to deal with this. And I'm okay with it. I really am. I don't mind. It's just, it is what it is, right, people? Can't do nothing about it. You could have a forge way down the road and, you know, maybe have a mini bike in down, you know, underground. So you can kind of like ride the mini bike down there so it's not such a long travel underground, but I don't know, whatever. I'll just have a horde by my house, and if I get screamers, it gives some excitement. Who cares? I'm okay with that. I can live with that. A lot of you guys who have been playing this game for a long time have been talking, well, not a lot of you guys, but some of you guys who've been playing this game for a long time have been talking about the fact that the hordes are about to reset. You know, all the way up till alpha, well, I don't know how long it's been like that, but basically the hordes would kind of reset at day 49. So your day 56 horde, the hordes would get stronger as time went on before alpha 15, and they would reset at day 49 and go back on day 56 to your first 7-day horde, which means really weak hordes for a while. And some of you guys are like, oh man, they're just going to reset again. This sucks, you know? No, that's not the way it works anymore. Madmole himself said that, oh my goodness. I will take that, my friend. Madmole himself has said as much. The hordes don't reset anymore. They keep getting harder based on your game stage, your personal game stage. And your game stage is based on how well you're doing, how many times you died, what your wellness is at, stuff like that. Although I don't know exactly what it's based on. That's the idea. So don't think that day 49 is the last exciting horde. It's not going to be. It's not going to be. They're just going to continue getting tougher. Once I get over there to the killing cage, I am turning it up to warrior difficulty. If it warrior difficulty, I feel it is necessary. I will give myself more zombies during the horde. Because, you know, 20 might not be enough. Make another 50 of these. Yeah, 20 might not be enough. So, yeah. For those of you, again, for those of you who are wondering what I'm talking about, and a lot of people do not know this, guys, so please bear with me. Last update, the Fun Pimps made the decision that they were going to introduce RMA zombies. What are RMA zombies? I don't know what RMA stands for, but they're kind of like just different looking zombies. That, you know, they're just different looking zombies, basically. And they're kind of like new zombies. And they introduced these RMA zombies, UMA. I'm really trying not to make that mistake anymore. They introduced these UMA zombies, but the UMA zombies cause a great deal of lag, basically, for lack of a better word. The performance hit is really bad. And because of this fact, the Fun Pimps had the brilliant idea, and I don't normally call out the Fun Pimps on their ideas. I trust the Fun Pimps to make the ideas they think are best for the game, and I'll play the game they make. But I got to tell you, they had this thing where you can only have 8 zombies at a time in a horde. And I don't know why they thought that would be a good idea, but it was a horrible idea. And it's made the hordes incredibly boring for the majority of people out there. But there are some people who figured out how to deal with this. And they taught me how to deal with it. Twitchy McNuts, one of the people who watches my videos, basically told me how to do this. You go in your, I'm not going to get into it, but you go in your game stage file. If you want to look it up, go look back in my episodes. I talk about exactly how to do it. But, yeah, so basically you go in there, you change a couple things on game stage or XML, and basically you can have as many zombies alive as you know, want, because the Fun Pimps make it only 8 zombies alive at a time for performance issues, but that's boring. And, you know, or maybe it's not boring. I don't know. If it's not boring for you, then that's cool. But it was boring for me, and it was making for boring videos. So you kind of just put that up to whatever you want. And I have mine at 20. So during Horde Nights, I'll never get any more than 20 zombies at a time, but I'll get 20 zombies at a time. So, and it's made my Horde Nights a lot more enjoyable. But I'm telling you right now, the killing cage, it's going to be a gauntlet. It is going to stop the zombies. I'm telling you right now, they're going to have like no chance, like zero chance. So I'm definitely going up the warrior difficulty, and I might actually up that 20 zombie limit to maybe 24. We'll see how the lag goes. I've changed a couple of my settings in the game on the multi. And I know this video is going long, guys, but whatever. What am I gonna do? Long video, you know. But on my multiplayer world, on my multiplayer Let's Play with Game Edge and everybody, we just went through the day 21 horde, and we have it set up to, I think, like 30-something zombies at a time or something crazy like that. And, yeah, so that was, and that's per person. At one point, I think we had about 175 zombies at the same time, because that whole, like, you know, 30 zombies limit was per person. Now, that doesn't always work, but it seemed to be working somewhat. Long story short, we just had a 21-day horde, and the lag was horrendous. I could barely move. You could watch the video, like, I don't know when it's coming out, sometime this week. But I was very upset at my frame rate. I couldn't move. I was getting single digits at points, and it would take me literally like a I'm freaking getting hammered here with this barbed wire. And yes, I do recognize that the barbed wire is hurting me. I'm just talking with you guys. Hold on a sec. So anyway, we had the 21-day horde. I could barely move. Like, I would click my mouse button. It would take me like 2 full seconds for my guy to like reload the hunting rifle. And then I would click the zoom in button, and it would take my guy like 2 seconds to zoom in. It was so frustrating. So that was really annoying. And I talked to Game Edge, and he gave me his settings. He wasn't having like many issues at all. So he gave me his settings, and I kind of tweaked a few of the settings in the game. And honestly, I don't really notice much of a difference. Actually, it might actually look better because I turned the UMA zombies up a little bit, because I think the UMA zombies affects the way I look as well. But I think I got rid of shadows. Shadows is a killer on FPS. If you guys are ever having issues with your game, with frame rate, take care of the shadows, because shadows is just a killer on frame rate. It's always been in every game I've ever played. So yeah, that might be a way to go. Yeah, take care of the shadows. So I did get rid of shadows, and I can't even tell the difference, to be honest. And so, not really that worried about it. And where is my spikes? Where are my spikes go? Are they down here? Are they up here? There they are. So anyway, I would like to turn up my hordes. Basically, what I'm saying is, when the killing cage is done, I'd like to turn up my hordes. But we're gonna have to see how the lag is and adjust accordingly, because, you know, I'm an old PC gamer. I've been playing PC games for a long time. My frame rate, I don't think it's too much to ask for 30 frames a second. That's all I ask for. And you know what? A lot of PC gamers wouldn't even settle for that. If they're not getting 60, they're not playing your game. So, yeah, I mean, I'll be okay with 30, but you got to give me 30. You got to give me 30. Yeah, I should probably get some wood. So, yeah, I mean, give me my 30 frames per second. And if I can't have them, then I can't turn the zombies up anymore. When I was doing some tests on how many zombies I can have during the horde, I think I put it up to like 30 or something, and then that was too much, and then I kind of put it down to like 24, and 24 was doable, but still a little laggy, so I put it down to 20, and 20 seems to be pretty good. I really don't want to go far for trees, but I don't want to cut, whatever, let's cut it down. Honestly, trees also brings you a lot of lag, so make sure there's no trees by your base. I gotta go hit the tree farm. I gotta write down what I gotta do. I gotta hit the tree farm. I got to... Oh, we wanted to go to the trader as well. So tree farm, trader. I've got a airdrop out there marked from the stream. So we gotta go get that and then work on the killing cage. That's what we're gonna be doing after this horde night. Alright, guys. I don't have anything else to say. My mouth is getting dry. I'm going to call this video here. I will see you for the day 49 horde. That's going to be it for episode 36. We'll see you next time for episode 37. Till then, take it easy.